there are a lot of Christmas programming come up. This, would you quit?
No.
You're an irritant.
Yeah, I am.
Is there something I can take for that?
No, I doubt it. No,
just gonna
there's
be
not.
Here.
A couple of weeks off might do it. I don't know. Anyway. Go ahead.
Jamie Taylor is here, and he's going to be telling us about a Christmas event that's going to be at the Lyric. And what day are you have two events or two separate days?
It's two nights, actually.
Okay.
It is December 14th and 15th, next Friday and Saturday at 7 p.m. at the Lyric Theater.
Mm-hmm.
And this year, with the Christmas show, it has been called Once Upon a Cold December Night. It is a family-friendly variety show that I have come up with, and has been in my theater awards before. You know, my process going into that, I select the music, then mm-hmm. select the singers. It's the same concept behind that. However, it's a mix of some of the traditional songs some people will know within, and there's a lot of contemporary with some newer songs that's mm-hmm. going to be actually unveiled that I have handpicked for different individuals that will be in the
okay.
show. And this year, it is free to the public. However, we are taking food donations for Children's Charity Ministry, CCM.
Okay.
Which basically we are asking that you bring items that they can put in the backpacks for the kids to send home during the day and the weekend to benefit those children that are less fortunate that actually.
Sometimes that's mm-hmm. the only really good food they get.
Correct.
From what I understand.
Correct.
And CCM is very proactive in supplying the food for the kids.
Yes, they are. And they are running short this holiday season. And so I know there's some other organizations that are working with them as well, but this mm-hmm. is something that I felt is very dear to me. It's no child should suffer during the holiday season.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Okay. So tell us. Tell us a little more about the show. I mean, can
okay.
you, any specifics you can give us?
I sure can. It's set in two acts, of course. Basically, we have Dixie Milburn playing our piano,
mm-hmm.
and we will also have some soundtrack music as well. We're going to mix it in there as well. Some of our local talent, which we're all very, very happy with, is we've got Lisa Johnson and her daughter singing in it, along with Ross Slavik. Juliana Stefanski, a lot of the familiar faces that you see down at the Lyric in our
mm-hmm,
plays
mm-hmm.
that are going to be in there. Some of the songs that you will hear, I know that we are doing the Christmas Time Is Here from Charlie Brown Christmas,
mm-hmm.
one of my favorite songs.
Mm-hmm.
One of the songs that I will be doing, actually performing, is actually how I came up with the name of the show. It's a song called Cold December Night. It was debuted a couple of years ago by Michael Bublé, which is on his Christmas album, and I just basically fell in love with. And so I'll be doing that one. And then there's a mix of some of the older songs. I know Jewel Stefanski singing Christmas Baby Please Come Home, which was a Phil Spector number mm-hmm. back in the 60s for, I think, Darling Love or something. And then we have some traditional, such as It's Beginning to Look a Lot Like Christmas,
mm-hmm.
There's No Place Like Home for the Holidays. And I Saw Mommy Kissing Santa Claus, you know, and just some fun mm-hmm. numbers right mm-hmm. there as well.
Mm-hmm.
And you have kids involved as well as adults?
We have a few. We have, like I said, Lisa's girls, Sophie and Callie, and then Anne-Marie Eaton and a couple of other teenagers
mm-hmm.
that will be involved as well.
Are there dress changes?
Actually, I'm not really a stickler for dress during this
mm-hmm.
one.
Mm-hmm.
There is a couple of numbers where I was pretty specific on for what I want them to wear.
Right, right.
But it's, I mean, pretty much when you're in this type of show, costuming's not my number one focus. I want to focus on the quality of the performance
mm-hmm.
more than
mm-hmm.
actually, I mean, well, of course you can't have a bad appearance on the show, but
right.
As long as the performance is, that's what needs to be shown,
mm-hmm.
and they need to shine in their performance more than their actual physical appearance.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Right. Well,
okay.
It sounds like it's going to be good. I look forward to it. I'm not going to be singing in it this year.
Mm-hmm.
It's one of those where I just went, I can't do another thing.
Mm-hmm.
So, but I look forward to, I know it'll be a lot of talented people there, and it'll be a wonderful, wonderful show.
It will. Mm-hmm. This year, my co-producer is Juliana Stefanski.
Mm-hmm.
Doing this type of show, I mean, it's very hard for one person to actually head it. She has done most of our groundwork, worked on getting the posters ready to go, the article for the newspaper that'll be coming out this coming weekend in the lifestyle section of the Harrison Daily Times.
Mm-hmm.
And she's been in constant contact with CCM about their needs and basically what we can provide, what kind of services we can provide for them.
Mm-hmm. Well, if you don't know Jules, she is a huge talent.
She's a go-getter, and she's the girl can sing.
She mm-hmm. can really sing. Mm-hmm. And not only just sing the words, but she puts a little
feeling in there, in her
there
personality.
Too, yeah. She goes, she knows, she has that star quality that when you go see a real star, whatever they have, she has. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, I was watching, I can't remember, I think it was during the Theater Awards, my wife and I were sitting together, and she goes, "Wow, that girl can really sing." Mm-hmm. I said, "Yeah, she's huge talented. Talent, so... it's worth the price of admission just to see her sing one song.
Anytime that girl touches the stage anywhere, I would be there to watch it because she is so talented in every field that she touches. Mm-hmm. And knowing, coming from a very, very shy girl that would not even look you in the eye, that she has blossomed beautifully, mm-hmm. and I think she's got a very bright future in anything she does.
Well, she's taking it by the horns, and she does an entire lot for the OAC and for the theater mm-hmm. company. We appreciate her very much.
We do.
Well, and you're appreciated as well for putting this...
Absolutely, yeah.
Well, it's one of those thankless jobs and stuff. This is something I've always wanted to do. I've done the Theater Awards for 6 years now, and this is something that I've wanted to do at Christmas time. And usually I'm pretty busy about this time with other events and stuff, but I thought, this is the year. We're going to do it this year. So mm-hmm. I approached them and said, they gave me the go-ahead. So
good deal. I know there's several things going on that weekend, but it sounds like you can fit with the dates that everyone has for everything, that you can fit something in every night and have a wonderful experience.
Oh, yeah. Excellent.
Come experience the Lyric at Christmas. There's no place like what we call our home for the holidays.
Mm-hmm. So. Right. Exactly.
And if you've never been in the Lyric, this is probably the first time to introduce yourself to it. Mm-hmm. It's a beautiful building. A lot of history that is going on right now inside the Lyric. You can see some of the old restorated wall art from Hobo of long mm-hmm. ago. So just come in, enjoy yourself. Most people that come in that have never come in before tell me, they say, "I didn't know this was here." Well, you just need to have a little, you need to be a little assertive and come on down and enjoy it while we're there.
Well, a lot of people really didn't know about the Hobo art because it was covered up when the OAC first bought the Lyric.
Yeah.
So, I mean, it was basically a new arrival back about almost a decade ago.
Yeah.
And
the roof was leaking, and mm-hmm. it was staining all that artwork, and it was fully restored. It took many, many, many months mm-hmm. to get it restored. So everybody at least needs to go down. It's almost a museum of history.
So. It really is.
Jamie, again, your event is the...
December 14th and 15th, okay. Friday and Saturday night at 7 p.m. at the Historic Lyric Theater on the Harrison Square.
All right. Thanks,
Jamie.
Thank
you, Jamie.
You're welcome.
Okay, let's take our last break, and we'll close out the show with a little conversation. Stay with us.